people believed that the end was near.
This wasn't a movie, this was real life.
I expected I would take these stories to my grave. Nobody'd ever know.
The Shah was trying to make Iran into a great power.
Kissinger wrote a memo and it said, sell the Shah of Iran anything he wants except a nuclear weapon.
People were not sitting around in Washington worrying about Khomeini.
He appeared to be a great democratic revolutionary.
Who would you bet on? The Shah or a bunch of people operating out of the mosque? By the time we got around to doing something, history had already passed us by.
As the revolution began to unfold, it became a lawless city.
It became clear that the Shah had to leave Iran.
Carter decided that the Shah should go to New York. The Iranians believed it was a CIA plot to put the Shah back in power.
That was what triggered the hostage seizure.
We had our hands tied, we were blindfolded. We very quickly became pawns in this game. Whoever controlled us controlled the government.
Seizing an embassy and taking the staff hostage was an act of war.
It marked the end of conventional diplomacy. Now that they're safe, how do we get them home?
And I had this notion.
The CIA proposed the movie scenario.
Argo.
They loved it.
It's almost cowboyism, gunslinger. That could have backfired into the most terrible tragedy.
A few miles away, our colleagues are basically being abused.
And I looked up at him and says, okay, I'm CIA, so what? May well be the worst pain I've ever had in my life.
I think Carter thought about every conceivable possibility, and that included military.
It was thought that the U.S. could mount a commando raid. It was a daring scheme called Eagle Claw. That's where the intensity was.
You had the possibility of saving people's lives.
You have to be prepared to lie for your country.